momentous and historic. That's how Malacanang describes the impeachment proceeding against Ombudsman Merceditas Gutierrez at the House Committee on Justice. For the first time in years, the committee will vote next week on whether or not there is probable cause to impeach the ombudsman. But a senator says the hearings were reduced to melodrama and theatrics. Will the evidence stand in trial?
From the battle in the House, we tackle the fight for the forests of Palawan. Civil society groups want to stop mining operations in the province, but businessmen oppose a blanket ban. Can the groups reach a compromise? And is sustainable mining possible in Palawan? I'm Lynda Jumilla.
And I'm Tony Velasquez. Join us as ANC presents The Nation Up Close.
A sixth grade student will know what she is up to. She was mastering the difficult art of doing nothing.
Lives of people are involved here, and therefore it is imperative for the ombudsman, whoever he or she is, to closely and meticulously examine all of these evidence.
Hindi ka namin pinipersonal, pero dapat ay hindi personal na interes mo ang dapat manaig sa paggamit mo ng kapangyarihan ng iyong opisina.
Oh, talaga? Wala? Oh, dahil kasi kaya siya nag-file ng case dahil yung kaso niya na-dismiss dito. Ay, sa halip na i-appeal niya yung dismissal ng kaso niya, dinadaan niya sa media by attacking my personality, my person, and my performance in the office.
Maraming mga ebidensya na or witnesses na hindi dapat papayagan. Diba? Kasi under the rules and evidence, kailangan na personal knowledge.
Pwede ba? Magbasa muna tayo tungkol sa impeachment. Yung mga legal documents about impeachment, its context, and its protocols in political science. We cannot just open our mouths there and vent off steam as if we were a volcano about to explode. It seems that these people are not even sure of what their evidence is. They're talking in generalities.
So as Senator Miriam Santiago says, are the lawmakers in the House just venting off steam? And joining us are the House Committee on Justice Chair Niel Tupas Jr., one of the lawyers for Ombudsman Gutierrez, former Supreme Court Associate Justice Serafin Cuevas, and Danilo Ramos of the Kilusang Magbubukid ng Pilipinas, one of the complainants who testified on the ombudsman's alleged inaction in the fertilizer fund scam investigation. Gentlemen, thank you for coming. Welcome to ANC. Si Congressman Tupas, nagsasawa na ata sa good evening sa atin. Halos gabi-gabi.
Man of the hour. Good evening, Congressman Tupas.
Sabi niya, huwag na akong batiin. Nakikita na kita halos sa araw-araw. But thank you again for coming, Congressman Tupas. Pleasure to have all of you, of course. Gentlemen, Justice Cuevas and Danilo Ramos. Proceedings in the House obviously will set, I don't know, maybe a legal precedent in a sense, because you see instances where people say the Supreme Court, you know, had somehow tried to interfere in a process that was strictly just for the legislature to decide on. But then again, proceeding with the impeachment, a momentous occasion, as one of the House the Palace spokespersons had said. Justice Cuevas, you are defending Ombudsman Gutierrez in
this correct.
Case.
That's correct. Right. It had been unluckily.
It's
a
tough job.
It's a very tough job. Precisely. Precisely. But what do you hope will become the legal lessons in this case? Because we're going to look forward now after maybe Attorney Anacleto Diaz last night said that it was sort of like presumed that the ombudsman is going to be impeached anyway.
Well, being akin to a criminal proceedings, I would like to believe that she still enjoys the presumption of innocence. Mm-hmm. And from there, that presumption of innocence will be rebutted when we go into the reception of evidence. Mm-hmm. And if the House Committee, chairman by my good friend, will finally find out that there is probable cause in the indictment against her, then an article of impeachment may be prepared and thereafter sent to the Senate. And that will be the time when the real trial of the case, no longer proceedings, but trial of the case, will certainly ensue.
Legal observers on this issue will say that the crux of the matter is whether or not the ombudsman had in fact not acted within its mandate to properly investigate, properly prosecute people who had been facing charges for so many years and therefore appearing as if she was protecting people who she enjoys favor with. Now, that is something that the ombudsman's office will have to shake off.
Now, the charge against her, in referring to that particular incident, is delay and not acting with punctuality in cases referred to her office. But I understand that all those cases are moving on. Some of them were there even prior to her incumbency as the ombudsman, and they were there when she came in. Now, because of the fear that she may be accused of protecting the first couple, she had inhibited herself and assigned the investigation or the taking cognizance of the case against them to a committee. And I understand the committee is functioning. Mm-hmm. I do not know, I am not very sure as of now as to what the committee had done in connection with the cases.
Lynda?
The accusation is delaying the proceedings or the disposition of these cases, or parang in effect sitting on them. But the exact phrase there in terms of impeachment proceedings is betrayal of public trust. Di ba parang medyo very subjective, very nebulous, na mahirap i-measure. So Congressman Tupas, paano ba mine-measure ito? Should it be, you know, people like Kadani, dapat ba feeling nila na betray ang trust namin kay Ombudsman Gutierrez? Paano mo susukatin yun? Paano mo masasabi that there is such a thing as betrayal of public trust in this case?
There are grounds for impeachment under the Constitution, Lynda. And one of them is betrayal of public trust. And the framers of the Constitution, of the 1910 Constitution, in their discussion, they included this as a catch-all
phrase.
It means that even if a matter would not amount to a crime, if it betrayed public trust, then the impeachable officer can be impeached. So the standard here is very subjective, as you say, as you said, because this is a political process. So it depends on the members of Congress, and in this case, the first stage depends on the members of the Committee on Justice. If they feel that there's probable cause that there's betrayal of public trust, then they will find probable cause. So it's really subjective. To me, it is more of how the people think. It's, to me, it's public opinion. It's how the constituents of, let's say, a congressman thinks. Because anyway, impeachment power is power of the people, and we're just here as their representatives.
Would it be the public in general, for example, or siguro the people who are most affected, for instance, of the omissions or commissions, alleged omissions or commissions that may have been committed by the ombudsman? Parang, for example, like I was saying kanina, should it be people like sina Kadani na, in the case of the fertilizer fund scam, they felt that they were betrayed because the issue was not expedited, at least as far as the ombudsman was concerned.
It could be, right? It could be, let's say, they can be part of that. But still, yeah, the Constitution leaves it to the representatives to decide what is the definition of betrayal of public trust. Not the Constitution did not leave it to the Supreme Court to decide. But it's a political, really a political process and a political. It's not even akin to a criminal proceeding, according to the framers. It's sui generis. It means it's a class
of its own.
Of its own.
Si Kadani, syempre hindi ko natatanungin siguro kung na-betray nga ba yung pagtitiwala ninyo, obviously. But why do you say that, bakit nyo nasasabi na may betrayal ng public trust? Gano'n ba katagal dapat ang itinakbo ng pagsusuri ng ombudsman? For example, dun sa kaso ng fertilizer fund scam.
Alam mo, Lynda, Tony, June 3, 2004, ito po yung isinumiti naming complaint. Mahigit na 6 na taon na po ang nakalipas. Wala po kaming natanggap at sa amin nga pong pagkaalam, kahapon sa pagdalo ko sa committee hearing ay hindi po nakarating sa number 2 o sa pangalawang
second
hakbang. Wala pong, hindi nila sinulatan na tumugon sila Jok-Jok Bulante at iba pa. At alam niyo po, para sa amin, napakabigat po yung mahigit 6 na taon na sa kalagayan po ng mga magsasaka, hindi pag-aari lupa, at yung pong 728 million pesos na dapat sana tinamasa ng magsasakang Pilipino, napakahalaga po. Kahapon nga po, nakwento ko na ito pong pale na to, dapat po marami ito. Dahil ko konti, hindi po pinakinabangan ng magsasaka, kasi po, one caban of fertilizer, ang katumbas po niyan after harvest season ay 3 cabans of palay. Equivalent po ng 9 na caban palay kung 3 cabang fertilizer. Isipin niyo po yun, 728. At 6 na taon po ang lumipas ay sa tingin po namin hindi lamang hindi niya inaksyonan kundi yung pag-prosecute. At hawak ko po itong committee report number 54 ng Senate. Alam ko po ito isinumiti sa ombudsman. Nakalagay po yung findings and recommendation sa page 33. Wala po. Kaya titingin po namin ay napakahabang panahon yun. Nakakarinig nga po kami. Kawawa naman si Ombudsman Merceditas Gutierrez. Para po sa amin, hindi siya ang kawawa. Ang magsasakang Pilipino na hirap, pero sa kabila po noon, dapat